Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today at the Fide World Cup it's game 2 of the grand final. Yesterday's game ended in a draw, but today's game was beautiful and decisive. Ding Liren with the white pieces against Teimour Radjabov with black. Let's get started. Ding opens with the English opening, c4, and Radjabov answers with knight to f6. Knight to c3, e6, and now if white doesn't want to enter the Queen's Gambit or the Nimzo Indian, he will play e4 like Ding did during the game. In fact, Ding continues with e4, and what is the idea? This line is called Flohr-Mikenas Attack. It's an aggressive setup where white immediately claims space in the center and is threatening e6, attacking the knight that must move back to g8. Radjabov continues with c5. This is black's sharpest idea, in fact, inviting the e4 pawn to advance, attacking the knight. Later black, because this pawn will be far from the other white pawns, later black will try to make this pawn a target. So let's watch what happens. After c5, e5 attacking the knight, knight back to g8, and here comes knight to f3. Watching the e5 pawn, also supporting a future d4 push. Knight to c6, and here comes d4. C captures, knight captures, the black knight captures the pawn on e5, black is a pawn up, but this is all fine. In fact, instead of trying to protect the e5 pawn the whole game, white's plan was to sacrifice the pawn for the initiative. This is a common theme in the Flohr-Mikenas attack. I have almost 1000 games in database with white that scores 56%. Here comes knight in d goes to b5. Of course, the idea is to jump to d6, we check, winning the black bishop, winning the bishop pair. In this position, playing d6 like in the Svechnikov doesn't work. Let's watch what happens. If d6 now, here comes c5, capturing the c5 pawn loses the game, because if now d captures on c5, comes bishop to f4, f6, bishop captures, f captures, now queen to h5 we check, g6, queen captures on e5, and nothing can stop this knight fork, knight to c7, winning material. Going back to c5 and d captures on c5, even queen captures on d1, now we check, after rook captures on d1, nothing can stop these two threats that are the knight fork and this knight that is under attack. So let's go back to our game. After knight in d jumps to b5, Radjabov continues with the best move, that is a6, attacking the knight, but the knight now jumps to d6, we check, bishop captures, queen captures, and the knight is under attack. Here comes f6, protecting the knight, bishop to e3, with the clear idea of castling queenside. Now knight to e7 and bishop to b6. The bishop, supported by the queen, is attacking the black queen. The black queen can't move, the queen is lost. So what to do? Black must make an equal threat to the white's queen. So here comes the best move, knight to f5, queen back to b4, knight to c6, a new attack against the queen. Also, it's a bit dangerous now to change the bishop on the queen, because this knight capturing the queen is also attacking c2. So here comes queen to c5, queen to e7, finally the queen is away from the bishop threat, and long castle for black. d6 now attacking the queen, queen back to a3, the only square available for the queen, and short castle for white. Now with the castling on different sides of the board, here comes g4, threatening the knight, knight back to h6, and rook to g1, protecting the pawn, with the rook on the same file of the black's king. And here comes knight to f7, this is a novelty, the game is original. This move better than f5 played before. So, the game is now original. White, with the bishop pair and more space, is just a bit better because of the initiative. Black is a pawn up and has two central pawns, but is a bit behind in development and without the bishop pair. So here comes f4, bishop to d7 that completes the development, and h4, a5, g5 now, and here Radjabov continues with king to h8. Not a mistake, but going back one move, a bit better is f captures on g5, h captures, of course, on g5, not f captures, because the plan is to bring the rook to the h5, attacking h7. But now here comes knight to b4, a good move because clears the cc square, where the light square bishop can move, controlling h1. Let's go back to our game. After king to h8, queen to b3, because of course the queen must become a bit more active. Rook in f goes to c8, and king to b1, always a useful move. And now it's black turn to find a good move. Here comes e5, attacking of course the weakest pawn, the f4 pawn, but the e5 pawn was controlling d5. Let's watch what happens. Here comes knight to d5, attacking the queen, also clearing the rank for the white queen. Bishop to f5, we check first, king to a1, and now queen to e6. In this position, not knight to c7. Let's watch what happens. If now Dean continues with knight to c7, winning this exchange, but it's not like that, because after rook captures and bishop captures, here comes knight to d4, attacking the queen, and also with the terrible threat of knight jump to c2, we check. So white in this position must give back the rook for just a tiny advantage. So let's go back to our game. After queen to e6, Dean continues with the best move, g captures on f6, g captures on f6, and here comes a3. Seems controlling b4, but this is an inaccuracy, because black can still move, can still jump with the knight here to b4, and white cannot capture this knight, or it's game over. Knight jump to b4 is the best idea, but here comes rook in a to b8, that is not the best move. Here comes another good move, because this bishop is still in the middle of the two rooks, but now must find a good square where to move. Bishop to g2 is good, because he's controlling e4. Now rook to g8, knight back to e3, attacking this bishop that can't move now to e4. So here comes knight to d4, but there is still this bishop that can capture. Bishop captures, e captures, and knight captures on f5. Queen captures on f5. Bishop to d5, a beautiful position for the bishop. There is still time to capture here on d4. Better to improve the position of this bishop. Not only this bishop is attacking the unprotected knight, the knight can't move away because he's pinned with the rook behind it. So Radjabov, at first he changed the rooks, rook captures on g1, rook captures on g1, but of course there is a big difference between this white rook on g1 now and this black rook on b8. This knight is under attack, moves to h6, and here comes queen to b6. The idea of course is to conquer the 7th rank and to give checkmate on g7, so of course there is no time for black to capture here on f4. Queen back to d7 is a good move, protecting the 7th rank, and now it's time for Ding to capture on d4. Ding regains the pawn that he sacrificed in the beginning of the match, and now he has a really strong position. The queen is also attacking f6, and will capture, we check. Also, the pawn can't move forward because he's pinned. So Radjabov continues with queen to e7, protecting the pawn. King to a2, this is a safe move, preventing any type of check. Knight to f5, attacking the queen and also the pawn here on h4. Queen back to c3 with the queen still on this powerful diagonal, pinning the pawn, also watching the pawn on a5. Of course, black can't capture here the pawn. Let's watch what happens. Knight captures, on h4, lose the game on the spot. Queen to h3, of course, if the knight moves back to g6, the rook can capture because the pawn will be pinned. And if now f5 with the queen that is protecting the knight, queen to c3 we check, and it's a forced checkmate because the king can't move away, the queen must move to g7 and he checkmate. So after queen to c3, what to do now? Here comes another inaccuracy, b6, h5, rook to e8, with only few minutes on the clock to think, Radjabov is not finding the best move, but already in a losing situation and black's position is collapsing. Here comes h6, of course there is a strong control here on g7, and after knight to e3, ding as the winning move. This is a blunder, because of course with less than 2 minutes on the clock it's not simple to find the perfect moves. Here comes rook to e1, pinning the knight, and Radjabov resigns. In fact, after knight captures on d5, the c-pawn will capture the knight. The queen can't capture the rook, because if the queen capture, the white queen will capture with check and he checkmate in one. And if the queen moves away, queen to f8, there is the rook capture that is a deflection, queen captures. The white queen captures with check, and again, is checkmate here on g7. So a fantastic game played by Ding, a great victory with the beautiful Flohr-Mikenas attack. I hope that you enjoyed the game, and as usual, if you did, please don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. Our video is over. For now, I thank you very much for watching, and see you tomorrow. Goodbye!